ஆழ்வார் எம்பெருமானார் ஜீயர் திருவடிகளே சரணம், ஜீயர் திருவடிகளே சரணம். ஸ்ரீ பகவத்கீதா ஹஸ் அ பியூட்டிஃபுல் காமெண்ட்ரி இன் தி நேம் ஆஃப் கீதா பாஷ்யம் பை பகவத் ராமானுஜா. வேதாந்தாச்சாரியா ஹஸ் கிவன் தாத்பரிய சந்திரிகை, விச் இஸ் அனதர் பியூட்டிஃபுல் காமெண்ட்ரி ஃபார் ஸ்ரீ பகவத்கீதா. வித் தி ஹெல்ப் ஆஃப் தீஸ் டூ சம்ஸ்கிருத வியாக்கியானம்ஸ், சம்ஸ்கிருத காமெண்ட்ரிஸ், புத்தூர் ஸ்ரீ உவே கிருஷ்ணசுவாமி ஐயங்கார் ஹாஸ் கிவன் பியூட்டிஃபுல் தமிழ் எக்ஸ்பிளனேஷன், தமிழ் காமெண்ட்ரி ஃபார் ஆல் தி பகவத்கீதா ஸ்லோகம்ஸ். ஹி ஹஸ் ஆல்சோ கிவன் வேர்ட் பை வேர்ட் மீனிங்ஸ் இன் தமிழ். வி ஹவ் டிரான்ஸ்லேட்டட் தட் இன் டு இங்கிலீஷ் அண்ட் வித் தி ஹெல்ப் ஆஃப் தி இங்கிலீஷ் டிரான்ஸ்லேஷன் வி ஆர் சீயிங் சிம்பிள் மீனிங்ஸ் ஃபார் பகவத்கீதா ஸ்லோகம்ஸ். வி ஆர் நவ் seeing 11th chapter, which is Vishwarupa Darshana Yogam. Bhagavan mercifully shows his divine universal form to Arjuna. He also grants divine vision to Arjuna so that Arjuna can behold this beautiful universal form. Seeing the universal form, Arjuna becomes scared and fearful, because he sees that all the warriors, all the people in the battlefield, they are all being consumed by Bhagavan. All of this creates fear in Arjuna's mind. But Krishna instructs Arjuna that you should fight here. Anyway, I have determined that all of these people in this battlefield will be killed except a few. So you should proceed and kill them and take the honors so that you will be glorified for this act. Hearing that, Arjuna is now going to start speaking. So that is the start of 35th shlokam. First, Sanjaya explains the situation to Dhritarashtra. He explains the scenario which he sees in the battlefield, and after that Arjuna will start speaking. So we'll start with the 35th shlokam. Sanjaya Uvacha. Yetat Shrutva Vachanam Keshavasya Kritanjalir Vyapamanaha Kiriti Namaskritva Bhuyayevaha Krishnam Sagadgadam Bita Bitaha Pranamya. So Arjuna's state is nicely explained by Sanjaya here. Sanjaya Uvacha. Sanjaya speaks. Keshavasya, Krishna's, etat vachanam, this speech, shrutva, hearing, kiriti, Arjuna, namaskritva, bowing reverently to Krishna, bita bita, being very frightened, Bhuyayeva Krishna Pranamya, bowing again to Krishna. Kritanjali, performing Anjali, joining the palms and being in a reverent, respectful state. Vepamanaha, shivering, sa gadgadam, aha, spoke with a broken voice. So Bhagavan is explained as Keshava here. Keshava means one who creates and controls Brahma and Isha, Ishvara, Rudra. Here, as the universal form shows Bhagavan's supremacy, he is addressed as Keshava here. So Sanjaya is saying that after Krishna completed his speech, Arjuna started bowing to Krishna, being very, very frightened and performing Anjali and speaking with a broken voice, having some shivers, because he has seen this very fierce form of Bhagavan, the universal form. He becomes very scared, and in that fear he is speaking now. Here Arjuna is going to speak some, I think, 11 shlokams. In these shlokams he brings out the greatness of Bhagavan and glorifies him greatly. So that is 35th shlokam. So hearing Krishna's speech, Arjuna bowing reverently, being very frightened, bowing again to him, performing anjali, shivering, he spoke with a broken voice. Arjuna vacha, stane Rishikesha tava prakirtya jagat prakrishyati anurajyate cha rakshamsi bithani disho dravanti sarve namasyanti cha siddha sangaha. Rishikesha, Krishna is being addressed as Rishikesha here. Rishikam means senses, Isha means one who controls. So here Bhagavan is addressed as controller of senses. He is not only controller of his own senses, but he is also the controller of all our senses. So he is being addressed as Rishikesha. Tava prakirtya, seeing your glory, jagat, all the residents of this universe, such as Devas, Gandharva, and others who are here to see you. So jagat means the world, but world is joyful, prakrishyati, that means everyone is joyful. World is joyful means the people in the world are joyful. So prakrishyati are very joyful. All of those Devas, Gandharvas, everyone is joyful. Anurajyate cha, revel in that. Rakshamsi, demoniac, bithani, being fearful. Dishadravanti, fleeing in all directions. Sarve Siddha Sangha, the groups of Siddhas, mystics, namasyanti cha, saluting you. Stane, all of these are very fitting for your glory. Oh, the controller of senses, seeing your glory, all the residents of the universe, such as Devas, Gandharvas, all of them who are here to see you, they are all very joyful and they revel in that, they celebrate it. The demoniac, on the other hand, being fearful, they are fleeing in all directions. Here demoniac means they are not necessarily like having rakshasa forms, but their attitude is evil, demoniac attitude. The groups of Siddhas, the mystics, are saluting you. They are seeing your greatness and they are saluting you. All of these are very, very fitting for your glory. That is 35th shlokam. 36th shlokam. Now 37th shlokam, first part. Kasmacha te na nameran mahatman gariyase brahmano api adhikartre. Mahatman, O great lord, gariyase, being big, brahmanaha api adhikartre, being the cause even to Brahma in all manners. Te, to you, kasmacha na nameran, how could they not bow? So Arjuna is wondering, if they know, if they understand that you are the origin, cause even for Brahma, then how can they not worship you? How can they not bow to you? Only due to jealousy, they may be ignoring you, they may be fearing and running away from you. Next, 37th shlokam and the beginning of 38th shlokam, end of 37th shlokam and beginning of 38th shlokam. Here in the commentary, the shlokams are adjusted and explained so that the meaning makes more sense, so that we can understand the flow clearly. So that is why we see sometimes that half of one shlokam and half of the next shlokam are explained together, because the meanings go together. Ananta Devesha Jagannivasa Tvam Aksharam Sadasat Tat Param Yat Tvam Adi Devaha Purushaha Puranas Tvam Asya Vishvasya Param Nidhanam. Ananta, O one who is not bound by three aspects, that is place, time and entity. Bhagavan is known as Ananta because he has no limitations. There is no end for him. He is not limited by place. He is present everywhere. He is not limited by time. He is present at all times. And there is no limitation by entity. He is present in every entity as Antaryami. So, Bhagavan is known as Ananta due to this particular aspect of not having any limits for him. Devesha, O Lord of Devas. So, Bhagavan is the Ishvara of all the Devas. Devas are considered as higher beings. Yet, they themselves have no power on their own. It is Bhagavan who is giving them control and power. And their position is given by Bhagavan. Jagannivasa, O Omnipresent Lord. So, Bhagavan is said to be present everywhere. He is known as Sarvavyapaka. He is pervading everywhere. Asat, primordial matter, which is in unmanifested state. So here, Moolak Prakriti is highlighted as Asat when it is in Karana state. When it is in the causal form, it is in subtle form. We cannot distinguish between different entities in the matter, in the Prakriti, Moola Prakriti. So that is known as Karana Dashai, or the state of cause, being the cause. So in that state it is known as Asat. And then Sat. Sat means primordial matter, the same Moola Prakriti, which is in manifested state, which is in manifested state. We are seeing trees, bushes, mountains, rivers, oceans and so on. So this is manifested state of the Prakriti, matter. And in this case of manifested state, we can see name and form. The differentiation can be done. In this case of unmanifested Prakriti, we cannot distinguish between each entity. Aksharam, the bound souls. Next, first he explained about primordial nature, Moola Prakriti, and then same Moola Prakriti in manifested form, and then Aksharam, the bound souls who are attached to this primordial matter. All the Atmas who are attached to the Moola Prakriti. Yat Tat Param, that those liberated souls who are even greater than such bound souls. So the liberated souls are free from this worldly connection and they are going to Paramapadam. They will enjoy fully. But bound souls, they are in this material world and they will go through the sufferings based on their karma. So both bound souls are the first level, and then there is next level, which is liberated souls who are greater than all of these. Tvam, you alone. So Arjuna is saying you are the only one who is this Moola Prakriti in causal state, Moola Prakriti in manifested state, Atmas, Baddhatmas and Muktatmas. But when he says you are all of these, that means you are the Antaryami of all of these and you are the one who conducts all of them. Tvam, you alone. Adideva, being the original Lord, Purana Purusha, the ancient Lord, Asya, Vishvasya, for this world, Param Nidhanam, the great resting place, Tvam, you alone. So Bhagavan is said as the Purana Purusha, Adideva. Adideva means one who is the cause, one is the original Lord. Purana Purusha means one who is ancient. Purana itself means the stories from ancient times, the incidents from ancient times. But every time we hear it is feeling like new. That is the meaning of Purana, the word Purana itself. So Purana Purusha means one who is very, very old. He has been here forever, such ancient Lord. Asya Vishvasya, for this world, he is the great resting place. Everything rests on him. So that is Bhagavan's nature. That is explained in this shlokam. So one who is not bound by three aspects, O Bhagavan. You are the Lord of Devas. You are omnipresent. You are the primordial matter who is in unmanifested state. You are the bound souls. You are the manifested matter. You are the liberated souls. You are everything. You are the original Lord. You are the ancient Lord. You are the only resting place for the entire world. All of these are said by Arjuna. Next, 38th shlokam. Vetasi vedhyamcha paramcha dhama tvaya tatam vishvam anantarupa. O anantarupa, one with limitless forms. Ananta we have already seen, that is endless, limitless. Rupa means forms. One who is having countless forms. Veta asi, you are the knower in all the world. Vedhyamcha asi, you are the knowable. You are the real person who knows everything. And you are the one who is to be known by us also. We all have to know about you from Shastram. So you are the knowable person, that which is to be known. Paramcha dhama asi, you are the great Paramapadam. Paramapadam is your wealth, your entity. So you are that Paramapadam also. Vishvam, all this world. Tvaya tatham, pervaded by you. You are pervaded by all this world. You are pervaded everywhere in this world. So Arjuna is, if we observe here, he is speaking in the terms of Vedanta throughout here in this particular section. Very nicely he is bringing out the Siddhanta from Vedantam and explaining it towards Bhagavan. Now 39th shlokam. Vayuryamognir varunas shashankaha prajapatistvam prapitamahascha. Prapitamaha tvam. You are the father of Brahma. Brahma is known as Pitamaha. Prapitamaha means father of Brahma, the grandsire. He is known as the creator. For him, for Brahma, Bhagavan is the creator. Bhagavan creates Brahma and Brahma subsequently creates Vayu as Vayu, deity for air, wind. Yama as Yama. Yama is the deity for Dharma. Agnihi as Agni, the deity for fire. Devata for fire. Varuna, as Varuna, the deity, devata for water. Shashankaha, you are Chandra. Prajapati cha, as Prajapatis, and their father Brahma. So you, who are the father of Brahma, is the one who is having Vayu, Yama, Agni, Varuna, Chandra, Prajapatis, and Brahma himself as your body. So everyone is under your control. That is the principle here. Because in the beginning itself, he said as you are the father of Brahma. Then when we say you appear as Vayu, you appear as Yama, that means you are appearing as all of these entities by being the Antaryami for all of them. Now, 39th shlokam, subsequent section. Namo namaste astu sahasra krutvaha punascha bhuyopi namo namaste. And 40th shlokam, first part. Namah purastat atah prishtataste namostu te sarvata eva sarva. Sarva. Sarva means one who is everything. Everything is having Bhagavan as Antaryami. So we can, if we say about any entity in this world, that will ultimately lead to Bhagavan only, because he is the Antaryami of all the entities. Te, to you, sahasra krutva, thousands of times, namo namaha astu, let my obeisances belong, I will fall at your feet thousands of times. Te, for you, punascha, again, bhuya api, and again, namo namaha astu, let my obeisances belong. I will again offer obeisances to you. I will offer pranamams to you again. Te purastad, in front of you, namaha astu, let my obeisances belong. I will come in front of you and I will offer obeisances to you. पृष्ठात् बिहाइंड यू नमः अस्तु लेट मे ओबीसेंसेस बिलोंग आई विल कम बिहाइंड यू एंड आई विल ऑफर ओबीसेंसेस टू यू सर्वतः एव इन ऑल साइड्स एट ऑल टाइम्स नमः अस्तु लेट मे ओबीसेंसेस बिलोंग लेट मी ऑलवेज ऑफर प्रणामम्स टू यू फ्रॉम योर फ्रंट साइड फ्रॉम योर बैक साइड फ्रॉम द साइड एवरीवेयर आई विल कम अराउंड यू एंड आई विल ऑफर यू ओबीसेंसेस One who is everything. So Bhagavan is everything. He has got everything as his sharira. Let my obeisances belong to you thousands of times. Again and again. Let my obeisances belong to you in front of you, behind you, in the sides, all the times. Let me be worshipping you, offering you pranamams always. So that is 40th shlokam, first part. And 40th shlokam, second part. अनंतवीर्याम इत विक्रमस्त्वं सर्वं समाप्नोषि ततोसि सर्व सर्वः अनंतवीर्य ओ वन हू इज हैविंग इनफाइनाइट एनर्जी अमित विक्रमः त्वं यू आर हैविंग इमेजरेबल प्रोवेस यू आर हैविंग ग्रेट स्ट्रेंथ सर्वं ऑल एंटिटीज अदर देन योरसेल्फ समाप्नोषि परवेडेड अस अंतरात्मा ततः हेंस Sarvaha Asi. You are called by the names of all those entities. Because you are Antaryami in every entity, it is sometimes seen that you are called by that particular entity itself. So they associate, sometimes people associate with Bhagavan as the Antaryami of all the entities. And they call out Bhagavan in all of those entities also. So in this shlokam is Arjuna is saying, one who is having infinite energy, you who are having immeasurable prowess, have pervaded all entities other than yourself. So Bhagavan is not the Antaryami for himself. He is Bhagavan. But all other entities are pervaded by Bhagavan. Hence you are called by the names of those entities. So whenever we say tiger, that means tiger, there is an Atma inside the body and then there is Antaryami inside the tiger. So this particular any name will mean Bhagavan only, will point to Bhagavan only ultimately. That is 40th shlokam completion. With this we will stop today and we will continue on in the next session. Alvar Embarumanar Jiyar Thirudigale Sharanam Jiyar Thirudigale Sharanam.
To learn such valuable information about our Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya, please download Koyil, K-O-Y-I-L app from Google Play Store or Apple App Store. Our website is koyil.org, K-O-Y-I-L.org.